You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at borisfx.com. Hello again. We are in part 2 of exercise 17, where we're looking at the stabilized module. And we're going to be taking a look at this shot as our next shot here. And we can tell there's a bit of movement to it. You can probably more easily tell that this is drifting if I just look at the start frame. I'm going to hit I to go to the start frame and O to go to the end frame. I'm just going to switch between those two. So you can see the buildings are moving. Not great. Okay. So that's what we want to try and stabilize out. Now, one of the things I get asked quite a bit is why don't we just use the automatic stabilization that, you know, a lot of software has built in. After Effects has built-in software for stabilizing, so has Resolve. You know, why not use that? Let's have a little look. If I duplicate this up, and I'm just going to come into our warp stabilizer. And this is the same warp stabilizer that's found across the Adobe product, so After Effects and Premiere, it's the same sort of thing. And let's take a look at this. I want to actually have no motion on this, so I can change that, and it's just going to start to, you know, analyze out the frame for me. And a little while later, it is now done with its stabilization, and let's just play that back. Okay, and that's looking stable, but there's something strange about it. Take a little look. I'm going to go I and O on this as well. So in point, out point. Okay, can you see that? Because the auto stabilization doesn't quite know what we want to stabilize around, it's picked up the clouds instead is the most stable thing. So it's stabilized out around the clouds. And because it's stabilized out around the clouds, check what happens to the buildings. The buildings look like they're falling down. And this is actually rather common. So we can see that as I scrub back and forth, just check out what's happening with the buildings. The buildings are collapsing in on themselves, which is, I mean, I'm not going to say it's not an interesting look, but if that was happening in my city, let's just say I'll be a little bit concerned. So what can we do instead? All right, well, let's actually come back to our original shot. Let's just bring that over the top. And I'm going to add in Mocha Pro. And let's just come into Mocha and do this properly. And the whole idea of this lesson is actually to make it very abundantly clear how important it is to choose what it is you're tracking against. So I'm just going to do a rough, loose shape across the buildings. I'm not going to spend too much time on this. There we go. What I don't want to do is I don't want to take in anything that's moving. So I don't want to take in any of these ships here. And let's see what happens when we do the perspective, just as we did in last time. And I will call this one buildings track. And let's just track that forwards. And this tracks in nice and fast. Don't expect any problems with this either. Excellent. And let's either come into classic mode or actually just show the parameters like we did last time. Come into stabilize, zoom to fit. And without doing anything else, I'm just going to do all motion and maximum smoothness, and we'll just play that back. And that's looking pretty good. And let's go to the beginning and just scrub it through to the end just to see if there's anything that's changing. And we can see we're looking pretty stable on the buildings themselves. There is still a little bit of movement going on at the front here. So if we want to get rid of that, let's see if we can do that as well. So I'm going to come in and I'm going to add another shape. And I'm going to add a shape to the front here. This is a non-coplanar shape. Okay, so just so we're both very, very aware that what I'm doing is not tracking in a coplanar object. but let's see the result we get out of it when I go to stabilize now. Again, all motion, maximum stabilization. Let's play that back. Let's just scrub that to see, because scrubbing actually helps us to see that a bit clearer. And you can see now that we're pretty much rock solid at the front and rock solid on the buildings as well. And the clouds themselves, well, they're moving nicely and naturally in a way that we would expect them to. So I'm happy with that. I'm going to hit save, exit out, come into my module renders, choose the module I want to render, which is the stabilized module, render that out. And let's do a, before I render this out, I'm just going to do a sort of split on this. So I'm going to use, a wipe line. So on the left-hand side, we have the automatic warp stabilizer. And on the right-hand side, we have Mocha Zone stabilized module. And I'll just scrub through that. And you judge for yourself which is the most stable on the buildings. I'm going to show one other thing in this section as well before we leave for the moment. And that's this one here. Now, this is quite an interesting little shot, because there is a little bit of, you know, bumping that we want to get rid of. But actually, there's a lot of movement that we want to keep. You know, we don't want to get rid of all of the movement, because the whole point of this shot is that movement from left to right. So how do we tackle something like that, where we just want to get rid of some of the little bumps in the movement without getting rid of the movement itself? Well, first thing to do is pop into Mocha, go into Mocha Pro, and let's see what a difference it makes where we stabilize around. I'm going to do two tracks. I'm going to do a track in the foreground. Let's give this a different color. And I will call this one foreground track. And I'm going to do a track in the background. So I'm going to make a new layer up here. I'll track something in the foreground. In the middle distance rather than the background. So somewhere around about there. I would call this one background track normally, but just to make it very clear that it is in the middle distance, I will call this one mid-distance track. Give this another color, one that's probably a little, you know, maybe a little bit different than what we've given the first one. Orange, there we go. Okay, and for these two, because we've got like a big sweeping camera move, you know, a longer camera move. It's not that long because the shot's quite short, but you know, we don't want to be chasing our tails on this one. We're going to do that little trick that we showed, you know, way, 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 way back, maybe exercise 4, where we talked about unlinked tracking. So I'm going to set my linked track to none on both of these tracks before I do any tracking. I'll set both of these types of track to just doing translation, scale, and rotation. We don't need skew or perspective in this one. In fact, if anything, that would, you know, throw the tracker off a bit more. And I'll turn on my grid in the middle distance one, just because that's a bit easier to see. And I'll track both of those layers through. Okay, and at some point, we can see that hit something that sent it going a bit rotatory, and it's obviously going to be this grass here. So I might retrack that middle distance one so we don't get too much of the grass in. But we'll see how this works out anyway. And we'll look at the foreground one. Well, that has a similar sort of issue as well. I think that's because this stick is causing trouble. We're probably not going to be using scale or rotation anyway. let's see what we can get. Let's come in, I'll right click, I'll turn into my parameters. The reason I'm not using classic mode is I actually quite like how the essentials palette is laid out. And we don't need too many other distractions right now. And when we go to stabilize, stabilize works off of the layer that we have our cog on. So if I hit play on this one now, in the foreground, and then I hit in the mid distance, you can see we're getting two very different results. Let's just zoom to fit. Okay, and with just the default settings, we're getting a nice sort of smoothed result. Let's turn on maximum smoothing, see what we get there. Very focused around that area. Love it. So it's an interesting result. It's not the result we want. Let's go to the mid distance and we'll turn maximum smoothing on. So we've got an apples to apples comparison. Because we're further in the distance, obviously, you know, that perspective change, that parallax change isn't as big. So we're not getting as big a result. But it's still giving us, you know, quite a big amount of black border because we are doing maximum stabilizing on this area here, which kind of looks quite nice. But we don't have to use maximum smoothing. We looked at this a little bit in the previous exercise. So in this exercise, we've looked at the difference in results that we can get between auto stabilization and using Mocha's stabilization. And with that, we've looked at the importance of where it is we place our objects. So what we're tracking is going to obviously directly affect how we stabilize the areas out afterwards. In the next and final part of our look at the stabilize module, we are going to be taking care of these black areas that we get, these areas of transparency we're going to get when we do our stabilization. And I'm going to show you a few little ways of dealing with those. But for now, enjoy your little break, and I'll see you again on the other side. You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version, available at borisfx.com.